Joe Rogan has finally revealed why exactly he decided in the waning days of the election to endorse Donald Trump, and his explanation is certainly something. Listen to this.
Well, I wanted to stay out of the presidential election.
Yeah,
it's gross. Because I feel like I had to. I feel like this is so nuts. This is so nuts. When that Tim Walz guy, it's so nuts that guy was going
to
be the vice president.
You're telling
me, you're telling me this whole thing's fake then. You're telling me you don't care if someone's a liar. You don't care if they lied about their military rank, where they served. You don't care if they lie about being an assistant. You don't care if they lie about Tiananmen Square. There's too many things. This is so crazy. You would get fired if you were an assistant manager at an oil changing company. Yeah.
Okay, so if I'm hearing him right, he decided to endorse Donald Trump. He decided to get involved in politics, which he didn't want to do, even though I guess he had Donald Trump on, because Tim Walz was too dishonest to allow Tim Walz to be the vice president, a largely ceremonial role. That's the argument that Joe Rogan, an incredibly wealthy person, has hundreds of millions of dollars and was one of the most influential people in the political realm. That's the argument that he gave. Now, I understand that we're all supposed to be very, very nice to Joe Rogan. He's an important person and you have to protect him from, you know, the natural things you think about the things he says. That seems kind of stupid to me. I know I'm not supposed to say that, but I feel like I'm going to. And I know what you're thinking. If it turns out that we were to look into it and Donald Trump had been dishonest in the past, well, in that case, Joe Rogan would look like a little bit of a goof. And so again, I didn't want to look into it because we're supposed to be very nice to Joe Rogan. But I did scratch the surface a little bit. I found a couple of lies. Apparently, 30,573 of them over 4 years. I mean, he's lied more than most people have talked. But Tim Walz was dishonest and thus he can't become VP. Now, I know what you're thinking. Okay, but that's like, that's a lot of lies and in so many different venues. You can't expect Joe Rogan to know that Donald Trump is one of the most brazen liars in American history. Well, okay, can I like expect him to know that he was lied to? Donald Trump told at least 32 verifiable lies to Joe Rogan in his appearance on the show. You know, little lies like that he won the 2020 election, even though Joe Rogan knows that's not true. He made clear on the show that it's not true. That lie doesn't count for the purposes of endorsing Harris or whatever. He lied about crowd sizes. He lied about immigrant murderers. He lied about Harris's work schedule. He lied about Harris working for McDonald's. He lied about the defeat of ISIS. He lied about who pays for tariffs. He lied about the truth of climate change. He lied about schools doing surgeries to kids to trans them. Those were all lies he said into Joe Rogan's ear holes, but that wasn't enough to get him to do the endorsement. Just the lies from Tim Walz. And by the way, we go specific here into the lies he told Joe Rogan. Even if you maybe say, well, it's just lies about the military that so triggered Joe Rogan, Donald Trump has lied more in that realm than Tim Walz could ever hope to if he lived to 300 years. Beginning, of course, with the fundamental lie about why Donald Trump himself didn't serve his nation. Because he got a cushy little thing because of the connections of his rich papa that diagnosed him with bone spurs that he doesn't have. And ever since then, he's lied about that. He's lied about the military and he's demeaned and besmirched the military. But again, none of that was enough to get Joe Rogan to weigh in on an endorsement. No, it was the lies that Tim Walz told that necessitated Rogan making an endorsement, Sharon. Now, I know I went over the line and I wasn't as polite to Joe Rogan as we're all supposed to be, but I kind of feel like he's a grown man. So I said what I said.
Yeah, Joe Rogan renewed his podcast contract for something like $250 million. And yet the bar for this fool, a sucker, is so low cockroaches cannot even squeeze under it. That's how low the bar is. And yet millions and millions of people tune in. Maybe they're looking for, maybe this is just a skit. He has roots in comedy and this is what he does. But it kind of looks like he's saying it like he actually means it and believes it, and then, you know, goes and puts on a tinfoil hat somewhere. It's just, it's fodder for nonsense until you realize how many people are sucked in. He was in this kind of negotiation with both presidential candidates, and he was deemed by the pundits to be the one that would make the difference. The guy is, this is Looney Tunes. This is actually Looney Tunes.
I mean, look, did Tim Walz say things that don't seem entirely true? Yes. So there, Rogan brought up, he lied about Tiananmen Square because Tim Walz said he was there when it happened, which is not true. He was there that month. He just wasn't there literally the day. So he exaggerated and he admitted that. Has Donald Trump ever acknowledged any of the 31,000 documented lies that he's told? Like, so Tim Walz centered himself by a week and a half in a historic event that he shouldn't have. So Harris can't become president. Just insane. They talked about the fact that Tim Walz had referenced in a speech, weapons I carried in war. Obviously meaning he was a soldier for literally decades, which he was. He served for decades, which notably Donald Trump did not do. Joe Rogan didn't even do. Tim Walz did serve. He could have carried those weapons in war. And in advocating for soldiers to not be put in harm's way, he exaggerated. He used poetic language or whatever. So obviously Harris can't become president. This is like, we can't pretend that this is substantive, that this is admirable, that it's just not. It's just not. You could pick almost any reason to have gone with Donald Trump. You could come up with reasons that I might even find arguable. You can just say, Joe Rogan didn't deliver, so I endorsed Donald Trump. Or I think he'll be better on inflation. I think that you're wrong, but you could say that. To specifically say it's that another politician is too dishonest is the reason you need to support the biggest liar we've ever seen in politics should be beneath anyone, even people who claim they shouldn't be held responsible for when they talk about politics, because he chose to. Members make a difference here at TYT. You help make the show happen, and we see you in the chat with your loyalty badge. Click the join button to become a member today.